In recent years, the popularity of Freecoaster hubs has skyrocketed. Unlike a cassette hub or a freewheel, Freecoasters allow the rider to roll backwards while keeping the cranks level. This allows for higher speed and more consistent rollbacks, and opens up a whole new style of riding. There are many different brands of Freecoasters on the market today, with many different features, but nearly all fit into two categories, cassette-based or clutch-based. Cassette-based Freecoasters, like this Profile Z Coaster and Salt Plus Trapeze, use pawls, springs, and a ratchet ring, very similar to a cassette hub. In fact, many can be ran as either a Freecoaster or a cassette by swapping out a few parts. Cassette-based Freecoasters are typically lighter weight and provide a more solid engagement. Clutch-based Freecoasters, like this Colony Clone and Cinema FX, have been around for many years with many different revisions. The majority of clutch Freecoasters use a clutch and ball spring mechanism, first introduced by Poverty and later mass-produced by KHE. This style has fewer moving parts and typically offers more slack than a cassette-based Freecoaster. So what is Freecoaster slack? Slack is the amount of pedal travel needed before the hub engages forward. Increasing the slack allows for a wider range of motion and correction when rolling backwards. While this is needed for fakie tricks, as it helps prevent accidental engagement, it also translates to delayed forward engagement when all you want to do is pedal. Another thing to consider is maintenance. While today's Freecoasters are more reliable than ever before, they do require periodic maintenance of cleaning and re-greasing of the internals. New Freecoasters also require a braking period. First, you might hear a popping noise while pedaling. Don't freak out. This is normal as the splines in the clutch are wearing in. You should also take the time to check your wheel alignment. If the axle is bowed or forced over in the dropouts, this can cause unwanted stress to the clutch and driver bearings. Don't force the wheel center. Allow the wheel to center itself in the dropouts. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and stay tuned for part 2 of our Freecoaster tech series.